People were very puzzled and confused. Why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say Ameen? Oh Allah accept. Ameen. Oh Allah accept. He said it three times. Why were they confused? Because there was no dua. There's no request. You say a dua, then you say Ameen. So the Prophet said Ameen, but there's no dua. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, what was that? So he said, Atani Jibreel. Jibreel, the angel that Allah sent to me, he was making dua. Oh, so the dua was from Jibreel. Yes, what was his dua? He said, Jibreel alayhi salam, O Allah, humiliate, ruin, destroy. Allahu Akbar. Who is it? The one who witnesses Ramadan and does not end up being forgiven. So the Prophet said, Ameen. May Allah accept your dua, Jibreel. Allahu Akbar. You might say, but Rasulullah is rahmatan lil alameen. The Prophet of Allah is mercy to all beings. Like, why? Why would he say Ameen? No, this is not a hit against the Prophet's rahmah. This is a hit against someone who does not care about Allah. How in the world can you witness Ramadan and still leave as a loser? It is very much impossible. You have to work very hard. Wallah, you gotta work perhaps very hard to leave Ramadan more miserable than before Ramadan. And inshallah, I want to share with you the four things Allah offers you in Ramadan. Four things no other month is being provided for. What makes Ramadan special? Number one, forgiveness. Yeah, forgiveness can be any time, any day we make tawbah. No, listen, the forgiveness package Allah gives in Ramadan, you will not find anywhere else. Let me give you three ahadith about forgiveness. Number one, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man sama Ramadan, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaba, two conditions. Out of faith, I have to do this. It's not culture, not because mom and dad does it. No, no. Iman, believe, I have to do it. Wa ihtisaba, and I hope for the reward of it. Then all of your sins are forgiven. All of them, if you do that throughout the month of Ramadan. طيب يا أخي, what if I have 1 or 2 days, I kind of, my fasting, you know, wasn't up to par, you know? Okay, no problem. Not saying no problem, but you got another offer. Forgiveness, yes. Rasulullah says, Man qama Ramadan, whoever stands up during the nights of Ramadan, after Isha, before Fajr. That period, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 raka'at you pray, you do that throughout the whole month of Ramadan, all of your sins are forgiven. Unbelievable, Allahumma barik. But brother, you know, sometimes I work, you know, night shift, and sometimes, you know, I get tired, I miss out on one night. Allah. طيب. Third hadith, catch one night. One night, wallahi one night. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man qama laylat al-qadr. If you stand up on one night, ya akhi, with faith and ihtisab hope, all of your sins are forgiven. Can you see that? This offers not any other month. That's one, forgiveness unlike any other type of forgiveness. Number two offer in Ramadan is a multiplication of reward. Ya akhi, I already know that. No, Ramadan is different. Fasting is different. Give me proof. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Rasulullah s.a.w. in the hadith, that your good deed to Allah is multiplied by 10. The good deed to Allah is multiplied by 10. So for example, your hourly wage is $10. Allah, the best of examples, you work for 1 hour, Allah pays you minimum, like you work for 10 hours. Not double time, 10 times, minimum. But then Allah teaches us, إِلَى سَبْعِمِئَةً, up to 700 times. Allahu Akbar. So your 1 hour wage of $10 an hour, no, now it's $7,000 an hour. That's how Allah does it, in the way that fits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as an example. But Allah says, Yakhi, where's the fasting? I'm coming. Allah says, except for fasting, these numbers do not apply. The 10 to 700, they do not apply to fasting. Allah says that. Why? Because it's a number that no one will ever comprehend. Allahu Akbar. May Allah allow us to appreciate Ramadan. May Allah allow us to appreciate fasting. Allah says, إِلَّا الصَّمْفَ إِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي لِي. I will personally, Allah said, I handle it. No angel will be able to understand it. No angel will comprehend it. No human being, no hadith will be able to provide it for you to understand the reward. So Allah says, I will personally take care of it. وَأَنَا أَجْزِي لِي. Give an example of the multiplication of reward. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, performing Umrah. Umrah, how long does it take? 2-3 hours. Umrah, 2-3 hours. The Prophet says, Umrah fi Ramadan ta'adilu hijjah. It gives the reward of Hajj if you do Umrah in Ramadan. But there's more. Multiplication of reward. What about Laylatul Qadr? Allah says in the Quran, Laylatul Qadr is equal to 1,000 months. La, no. No, brother, it is khayrun min alfi shahr. What's the word? Khayr. It is better than 1,000 months. So Allah knows the limit. So one night of Laylatul Qadr, you worship Allah, it's like almost more than 83 years. So if you witness 30 Ramadans in your life, It's like you lived 2,400 plus years. 2,400 years old of ibadah to Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. You see how the Prophet said Ameen? Now you feel him? Now you see why he said Ameen? May you be destroyed because you gotta be a miserable human being. Type, that's a multiplication of reward. Offer number 3 out of 4. Lifetime pass protection from hell. Forever. How is that? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Inna lillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selects during iftar time. When iftar time comes, Allah selects people to be freed from hell forever. Think of like you got a membership, you will never go to hell. Period. Type, brother, what if that guy gets that pass? They will never go to hell. Allah chooses them, but they end up being a kafir. No, Allah will not make them a kafir because of that one night. Allah will protect them. Allah will guide them in every way possible because Allah never breaks His promise. If I say you're freed from hell, you are freed from hell, period. When you are selected, that means you gotta work hard. If I tell you at your company, every day they pass around a $10,000 bonus, what will you ask? What's the requirement? So if I tell you every night Allah frees people from hell, you will say, how can I get selected? That's what a believer should behave in wonder. So I'll give you an example, is that you gotta work really, really hard. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look what the Sahaba said about him. كان أجود الناس. He was the most generous human being that ever walked on earth. His generosity is unbelievable. Are you ready? وكان أجود ما يكون. And his generosity goes to another level in Ramadan. Ya Allah. So because of utaqa, there's freeing from hellfire, there's forget, all that stuff. So please, please. Sometimes people say statements without thinking, wallahi. Akhi, ana my Ramadan is like before Ramadan. Subhanallah, my schedule stays the same. I always read Quran. Akhi, shame on you. Hey, to say stuff like that. Rasulullah was able to upgrade his ibadah. He was able to upgrade. You say, well, my Ramadan will be like before Ramadan because I work really hard. No, you gotta be humble. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan is a whole other level of ibadah. Ramadan was not meant for us to go to Florida and take a vacation. Ramadan was not meant for us to do things that can be postponed to after Ramadan. The last 10 nights of Ramadan, what did the Prophet do? Sleep is over, it's time out, no sleeping. You sleep in the day. The business, yeah, business by then. Use your vacation days. Vacation days, last 10 nights of Ramadan. That's what the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they learn from them. إِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَاشِرُ When the last 10 nights they enter, what happened? He rolls up his sleeves, Rasulullah, in an example. And then وَإِشْ And he ties around his waist. وَأَيْقَذَ أَهْلَهُ And he wakes up the whole family. Let's go. Let's work hard. All night long, the last 10 nights. This is the attitude of the believer in Ramadan. Fourth and last one. Allah promises to make you happy. Promise. Give us proof. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us how Allah says, إِنَّ لِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ The one who's fasting has two moments of extreme joy or of high level joy. The moment you break your fast, and we all know how exciting that is, right? What do we have for iftar? That happy moment, the Prophet says, that's one of the two. What's the other moment of happiness? Allah teaches us, وَفَرْحَةٌ حِينَ يَلْقَى رَبَّهُ The day you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What will happen? Surprise. Allah. When the king tells you in this world, if a king tells you, I got a surprise for you, you expect the gift to be equal to the wealth of the king. If a king tells me, I have a surprise for you, I will think he has a Bentley for me, Bugatti, something like that. Because a king, he's not giving me a Toyota, with all due respect to Toyota owners. Allah Jalla Jalal, the best of examples, the king of all kings, he says, I got a surprise. One last hadith about surprise and happiness. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Inna fil jannati baba. In Jannah, there's a door called Ar-Rayyan. That's the name of the door. May Allah make you all enter through it, Ya Rab. The Prophet says, Yawm al-Qiyamah, there will be an announcement. Ayna al-Sa'imun? Where are those who used to fast? Fayaqumun. They all stand up. May Allah make you of those who stand up. Fayadkhulun. And they all enter that door. And once they enter, the door is locked. No one else enters. Hadith stops. But what's in there? Surprise. Ya Allah. Reward of Ramadan? Surprise. What's in Jannah? Surprise. That makes us even more excited.